Tonight, KCRA3's down with a crew as they responded to calls. And Danielle, we understand not a lot of downtime tonight.
You know, Edie, that's right. Firefighters say they're getting calls for help right now for things like grass fires. And just take a look over to my right at the station where I'm at. Firefighters are sitting on standby. You know, on a night like tonight where fireworks play a big part of the fun, it's hard for them to find a chance to relax.
The time on the clock, 6:06 p.m. And the paramedics at the Sacramento Metro Fire Station 105 are pulling back into home base. They had just finished rescuing a person suffering from multiple seizures. It was the station's fourth call for help of the day.
Pretty much, I think we're going to be up all night.
The morning had started out easy with this parade in the Sierra Oaks community.
Just told the guys just to stand down a little bit.
But by evening, Captain Phil Lopez had changed his tune, strategically trying to squeeze in dinner.
Don't make anything too intricate because, you never know when you're going to get a call.
Tim Beard may just have jinxed himself because as soon as the firefighters bit into this spread, that call came through. Not one, but two. First a medical call, and minutes later a gas leak at an apartment complex.
That's a major emergency. You've got gas, you know, flammable gas in there, and any type of ignition, any type of spark could set that off.
The firefighters fixed the problem, a leaky stove, and headed back to station 105, all within the hour. Almost quick enough to save this steak dinner.
Lukewarm. It's still good, though. All part of the job.
Just to give you an idea, Lopez says on average his firefighters respond to about 7 calls for help a day. He says the medics there get an additional 9 calls for help, and he says it's hard to predict, but on a night like tonight on the 4th of July, he says that can easily double. Reporting live in Sacramento, Danielle Lee, KCRA 319.
Glad they at least finally got that well-deserved dinner. Danielle, thank you.